and you can see all the way to the mountains in the distance, about 20 miles. There's also a lake down there at the bottom, the Stockbridge Bowl, where Tanglewood is. So you can see that as well. The breeze would come up the hill and go right through the house. That's why this house is called there. Remember, the 1890s, if you made a dollar a week, it was a miracle. By the 1920s and 30s, labor had caught up to a more reasonable level, and therefore nobody could afford to maintain these houses anymore. So that's why when it was sold in 1943, it was sold for $25,000. Hard to believe in that entrance. But when you got here, it was party time, so this room was used for dancing, believe it or not. You needed music, no problem. The orchestra would be right in that gallery above the front door. That was specifically designed for the orchestra. So the ceiling here, this is called a coffered ceiling, English style, kind of Tudor, if you will. Once again, Sarah loved English things, Jacobean style, Tudor, etc. These are pine beams that are covered with oak veneer. But when I say veneer, I mean half inch oak. So, now, these panels, why we have all the different colors. Well, all paneling had been ripped from the walls when we took over the house in 1997. We found all these pieces all over the place, up in the attic, down the cellar, all over the place. So when we found an original piece, we put it back up on the wall. If we couldn't find the original piece, we recreated it. So this wall here is all original. This guy here is the jigsaw puzzle. By the way, all the pocket doors. It's the last thing that Sarah had added. The first fireplace wasn't nearly grand enough, in her opinion. So she had the architect get her two pieces of French limestone up to here on one piece, and then the top half. Between the two of them, they weigh over 5 tons. They even had to specially reinforce it down beneath. There's steel girders and whatnot to make sure it doesn't collapse. It was a mahogany layout. The hallway was all oak. This is all mahogany. So this part of the ceiling is original. The rest of this is all a recreation. The ceiling in this room had collapsed because of all the plumbing on the second floor. Leave a house vacant for almost 20 years. We know what happens. So we are lucky that we have a period picture on the table here of what the dining room looked like when the house was built. One thing is missing from the old picture.
The chandelier?
You got it. No chandelier. Sometimes ladies of the Gilded Age did not like lighting from above. They said it was not flattering enough. It's up and downstairs. But that is the butler's pantry and the cabinets. Built in there are replicas of what the cabinets were. This one here, all replacement. This guy here, replica. Snuck a Japanese gal in here. You may be wondering what Yuki is doing here. Well, George and Sarah had 3 children. Their middle child was named George. He's a black sheep. There's no other way to put it. He, in 1894, he's involved in a huge scandal. During parties, this is where the guys would also hang out. Just imagine huge clouds of cigar smoke. All the windows in this room are original. The lighting fixtures, the black ones, are also from the 1890s. And also the coffee ceiling. We're back in oak again. Now this fireplace, the marble is from Italy, of course, and we had to rebuild it. It's like a mini rebar system. We put it back together. The columns are also from Italy, but they're a lot older. They're from the 1600s. Not uncommon in the Gilded Age for people to go on their grand tour and liberate architectural antiques from palaces, castles, etc., and bring them back and use them in their mansions here in the United States. Literally wraps around to the front of the house, where it also hooks into another staircase that goes down to the cellar. So this way a servant could greet a guest at the front entryway, disappear, bring up more food or booze as necessary, disappear.
Oh yeah, they do.
Yeah, these were painted by a student of Rembrandt.
guy named Bartholomew. Yeah, so this was George's bedroom.
That's great.
And we have it.
So cool.
What is the door made out of?
This is a sheet metal pipe.
Yeah.
And then in here, this is all sheet metal, so there's probably a locking mechanism here. When it was a girls' ballet camp, of course, they decided to give us some graffiti. No problem. And then, but this is what it's supposed to look like. And I'm sure they had some sort of a painting of hinges along here.
Yeah.
It screams out for a balcony, especially when you consider when the house was built, there were no trees there, and you could see all the way to the mountains.